Okay, are we ready?
Always keep your net in the water. Never know what's gonna swim in it.
Nice. Did you see something?
Aquatic worm. Ocelot.
Miller Lake is a quiet, unassuming place. But these gentle waters are also home to a creature that's as elusive as it is otherworldly. The Miller Lake Lamprey.
Did you get it?
Yeah, I'm trying to.
Well, these are very fascinating native fish. They're totally blind, have no eyes, and yet they're doing a very nice job of avoiding us. The equipment we have produces a relatively low voltage electrical current between the tips of the two poles. It doesn't electrocute the fish, but it sort of irritates them and they move up out of the sediment, and that allows us to see them and hand net them. We refer to it as our tickler.
Oh, here's the right there.
Fair warning here, if you like your wildlife warm and fuzzy, check your expectations.
Nice catch.
Subjectively speaking, the lamprey these folks are after are unusual. Some might even call them creepy.
This is one thing people never think about when they're wading around in a creek with their toes in the sand, is that they're surrounded by lampreys.
The Miller Lake lamprey's ick factor isn't helped by the fact that it's also a parasite. This is the smallest parasitic lamprey in the world, and its evolution has led to some unusual features.
There's no bones in these fish. They've got no jaws. See the mouth there, it's a funnel.
It's only as adults that the lamprey even grow eyes, but it's their mouths that most people notice. These things that look like teeth, they're used to drill into larger fish so lamprey can suck their insides out. Fun, right?
There's much that's unknown about them. They are cryptic, they are weird. People think they look like aliens.
We keep sucking onto my finger.
You want to get it off you before it takes fluids out of you.
I mean, I don't feel it. I can see that it's stuck on my hand, but I don't feel anything.
But we wouldn't bring you a story that was just about an odd fish. These lamprey are important to the health of the lake and everything in it. Lamprey begin life as water filters, cleaning out algae and playing a role in the cleaning of the lake.
So they have a very important role in the ecosystem as filters, and also sort of like the earthworms in your garden, they're turning the bottom of the creek.
Oh, there's a whole bunch.
And also they provide a major food resource. Any other fish who can grab a lamprey eats it.
Come on.
What's amazing is that we're even able to show you this lamprey at all. Because for decades, this odd yet extremely useful critter was thought to be extinct. Intentionally extinct, in fact, because the Oregon Game Commission, as it was called in the 1950s, thought lamprey were nothing more than a nuisance. Fishermen didn't like lamprey latching onto their trout, and so began the campaign to eradicate them. The Game Commission dumped barrel after barrel of a potent pesticide, toxaphene, into Miller Lake. It's a chemical so nasty that it's now banned worldwide. And to seal their fate, crews also built a barrier on Miller Creek to prevent any surviving lamprey downstream from returning home. It wasn't until a generation later that the agency, now known as the Oregon Department of Fish and Wildlife, realized their mistake and saw that deliberately eliminating a native species wasn't such a great idea. Then, in the 1990s, a curious biologist's discovery gave the agency a chance to right a wrong.
One of the local Forest Service biologists here had a lamprey hooked onto a brook trout downstream from the barrier. Once it was identified that Miller Lake lamprey existed, it kind of put the wheels in motion on, well, shoot, what are we going to do?
So they drew up a conservation plan for the native lamprey, a first for a non-game fish in Oregon.
We kept it pretty simple. Maintain good habitat in the areas where it was. And we decided it was time to move lampreys from downstream upstream and bring them into the lake.
This looks like a good spot. What do you guys think?
Hey, it looks great.
Since the early 2010s, the team has been hauling lamprey by hand to the top of the lake, one bucket at a time.
615 fish.
That does it.
The team has successfully returned lamprey populations in the streams that feed the lake, but they haven't found any in the lake itself. Until they do, they'll need to keep working.
The way this group works, we all sit around the campfire and we talk. And I think any visitor to the campfire will be impressed by the glaring level of ignorance that all these fish experts have on lampreys. So here's the question. What did we learn this afternoon?
People are having fun. There's almost no crazy idea that isn't at least entertained.
And the abundance was beyond low. It was scattered, I would say.
Not entirely sure what that means. I mean, it couldn't mean any number of things. I'd really like to check out Evening Creek tomorrow and see what we see compared to the last couple years. What do you guys think?
That could be someplace where they're spawning.
Evening Creek feeds into Miller Lake here. Ben and his team are hoping to find small lamprey, an indication that relocated lamprey from years past are reproducing.
We're hoping to get it back in the lake.
That's the whole plan here. We're just trying to see if they are reconnecting.
It's like trying to find a needle in a haystack.
It beats the office.
There we go. Hey, we got one! Little guy.
Really? Very cool.
Look at that tiny guy.
Is that what we're looking for?
Whoa. That's exactly what we're looking for.
This looks a lot like reproduction.
Very cool.
Out in the delta of the creek, there has been natural reproduction, which is very exciting.
Is this evidence of recolonization of the lake? I would say we don't have quite enough information to conclude definitively yet, but it's exciting that maybe they are going into the lake. Let's keep our finger on the pulse and see what we find.
Success will be if lamprey recolonize the wider lake, where there'll be food for other animals, and where, as larvae, they will once again do their job as filter feeders, devouring algae and cleaning the water.
This is the most exciting thing that I've been part of. Rediscovery of the animal, seeing success within my lifetime. I'm hoping that we see Miller Lake lamprey actually in Miller Lake. It's going to take some time, but we're well on our way.